Prayer may just be the most powerful tool mankind has. Now let us all rise up for silent prayer. Thank you all for strengthening the prayer.
Morning, friends.
Morning.
How are you this morning? All well? Okay, guys. Let me thank your department first, IT, Computer Science Department, who has given me this opportunity to come and stand in front of you and share my thoughts and experiences. I just want to, because before I start about logistics and shipping, I want to listen to some of the students. Maybe if you can pass on one more hand mic to the students. What do you want to know from me? I will tell about logistics and shipping. See, I am here because end of the day, I have been doing hundreds of seminars. I kept traveling. I visited more than 50 countries. I visited more than 500 ports in the world. Because I started working when I was 16 years old. When I was 16 years old, my parents didn't have money to make me study graduation like all you guys are doing. So I started working at 16. Thankfully, I got into logistics and shipping. So I'm here. See, there has to be some constructive meaning in life. You know, I coming and talking to you for 1 hour. It cannot be just an academic exercise or, you know, or for record books or something. Okay, you know, we have met and we have done. I want to know, okay, I also want to tell you something. There will be some of the students who will say, I'm never going to leave Coimbatore. I am not traveling across India. I'm able to connect all the students. I've learned Tamil and Hindi during my process. I'm more useful to a lot of other students too, right? How many of you students want to go overseas, abroad, Dubai, America, Europe, and make a big career for yourself? Please raise your hands. Don't hesitate. Oh, very good. Some of you are there. Okay? Why the rest of you don't want to go and explore the world? There's only one life. Okay, how many of you says, I don't mind going out of Coimbatore to Chennai, Delhi, Mumbai, Bangalore, wherever it is, and make a big career in my life? How many of you willing to leave Coimbatore at least? Within India. Okay, some of you are there. I know rest of you don't want to leave Coimbatore, but believe me, you're the biggest mistake. It's not about Coimbatore. I'm not saying you stay forever outside Coimbatore. The problem is students, parents, with everybody. And this, for me, especially for boys, girls, we are in India, I can't speak, then you will say you're revolutionary types. I can't speak here about American style, European style, but global style. But believe me, only when you go out, explore the world, learn something, then you can come back to Coimbatore. You'll be more useful to Coimbatore then. I'm not saying go out of Coimbatore and even die somewhere else. I never meant like that. Today, I traveled, in 10 years, I traveled 50 countries, 500 ports. I've come back to Chennai because I love my pongal vada. I can never, you know, the one reason my friends ask me, because my friends, they're there in US, Dubai, Singapore, Shanghai, Moscow, London, everywhere. So PK, why you are not coming there? Oh, I mean Sangeeta, I mean not that Sangeeta. I mean Sangeeta Hotel, okay? Sangeeta Ella. So you get the Pongal Vada and Marina Beach and Express Mall, you can't leave it. Certain things becomes part of Lachar in Chennai gives me everything. I'm happy in Chennai, but I'm traveling. You know, I go meet my friends. Today technology is there, I don't miss anything. So my first advice to because there's no point in me talking to you about logistics and shipping. If you have some mental blocks in you that will stop you from... See, I realized one thing, every human being, each one of you sitting here, I can see a Steve Jobs, I can see one Indira Nooyi, I can see one Narayan Murthy, each one of you are the best human beings. Every one of you sitting here has potential. The problem is you don't believe that. Hey, you are lying to me. How do you know about me? I'm meeting you first time. No. I am like this. Okay. Wow. So Swami Vivekananda said, human beings are not just flesh and body, flesh, it is just not that. Human beings are beyond flesh and body, we have intellect. What's the difference between onion, brinjal, potato and human beings? They are vegetables, they are human beings, right? But what is one? They are also like, they are like, right? You are science students, no? All of you. I was told all of you are IT science students, right? So what is the difference between a vegetable and a human being? Kya farak hai? Vegetable or? Oh, your friend was supposed to say vegetables have brains, they have brains. Almost, oh, that you corrected. He was almost saying they have brains. Wow, they can't understand, but they would have heard of what you're telling them, they are very happy. Can't believe, man. See, it's not about having brains, whether you use it or not. Application. It was told that ordinary human being uses only 5 to 10% of his brain. You can use almost 30 to 40%. No, I will not use. It's so tiring. Please use your brain. That only six packs, not only here, you should have six packs in your brain also. Then you look more beautiful. So that's one point. So I am here for those students who are saying, yes, Captain, I'm ready to go out, explore the world. You're welcome. Because I have signed about 100 MOUs in Dubai. So whomever wants to go to America, London, UK, explore, I'm there to help you, assist you. Point number two, for those who say, okay, fine, I'm not saying overseas career itself is everything. Even if you're willing to come to Chennai, Bangalore, Delhi, Bombay and say, Captain, you know, yes, I'm willing, okay, I cannot go, I don't have aspirations to go outside India because I'm addicted to Sambar Sala. So I will be here only. That's a different issue. But believe me, this logistics and shipping industry will give you adequate opportunities to explore the world. The world is your playground. Do you understand that? The world, entire world is your playground. It depends on you whether you want to play the game or not. And my colleagues told me when I came here in the morning, in fact last year I did a presentation here. I have 10 students from your college. 7 of them are from commerce and 3 of them are from IT department. I wish it would have been the opposite side, 7 from IT and 3 from commerce, because my dear friends, whatever it is, on my face value, trust me on one thing, the combination of computer science plus logistics is a deadly combination. You can be in the IT department of a big logistics company, or you can be in the logistics domain area working on logistics of an IT company. In an IT company, they don't have people with logistics domain knowledge. Banking, finance, health, agri, credit cards, mobile apps, 99 different types, hundreds of people are there in all those domains. You should be something special and unique. Yes, sir. Right? You can't. See, I'll tell you one more thing. The human beings have one disease called herd mentality. H-E-R-D, herd mentality. What is herd mentality? Be with the group is not herd mentality. Be with the group is teamwork, there is one. Herd mentality means one goat will go that side, other goats will see. That goat is going that side. Doesn't it happen? Why did you join BCS, IT, whatever? No, my friend does. My friend joined, so I joined. I ran to fair safe call, college, I ran to fair safe call. And I joined. No? Oh, in Chennai, I have many stories. I have to ask my friend, he did some research work and he's doing his PhD in medical dental science. But then, suddenly from there, he's from Salem. He was working there, and why you came? No, no, my, you know, my uncle's daughter, she's taken up MSc here in Chennai, SRM College, so. Okay. Now you came here because of that. You cannot plan your career or courses or life or colleges based on such frivolous things. Then you can't have a life. Don't play with your career and your life, because if you lose it once, you can never most of you understand Tamil, right? What do you call in Tamil job? Oh, you're Tamil experts. Fine. Okay, my second question to you. What do you call career in Tamil? Why all silent? Tholil is profession. Valka is life. My friends, I came here all the way from Chennai. So if you don't want this session, you're welcome to go. If you're so busy on the mobile, you can keep your mobiles outside or close the mobiles. Please do not insult your faculty. Not only me, my talks. When any faculty is talking to you, they are standing in front of you. They chose to stand in front of you. They choose to stand in front of you and deliver a lecture. So if you take out one mobile phone, you know, this thing and keep doing like this, it is directly insult. It is not about me. I don't mind. I come from another and I go. But it will pain your faculty. It will pain your faculty who is standing in front of you. Because your faculty are like candles. Your faculty are like lighthouses giving directions of your life. You won't realize now. When you become 30 years old, you will realize. Because today brain is not yet mature. The brain must be minus 5 years or minus 10 years. That is a problem. Don't underestimate when somebody comes and stands in front of you and talks to you. You never know who's coming in front of you. You don't know that guy's background. So I'm standing in front of you after visiting 50 countries, my friend, and I chose to come and stand in front of you. So, see, this is what life is all about, finding out value. Where is my value? What should I do where I get maximum value? If you can't identify value when the value is there near you or in front of you, whether it's your faculty, in your placements, in opportunities, in terms of your books or knowledge or library or assets, computers, parents, friends, if you don't understand the value of value, you become valueless. Your value will be zero. Because you don't know the value of value, then obviously it will be zero. Right? So be very careful, because every opportunity you miss in your life, you are finished. Because you may have the talent to go on Mount Everest. You want to go on Mount Everest. There's a bus for Mount Everest. And when the bus came for Mount Everest, you are on the mobile. And the bus went away. How do you reach Mount Everest? Be very careful, keep your eyes and ears open. Opportunities and a lot of things are around you. You should pick and choose. Okay? We have IITs in India. We have IIMs in India. My dream in 2007 was, why not IIM? Because people did not know logistics and shipping as a career. So it has, in 2007, in fact next year we will be entering our 10th year. In 2007, we took an initiative saying that if people, India is known for technology, India is known management, why not India can be known worldwide for logistics education? So that is how Indian Institute of Logistics came into existence, a dream of few people, to train people into logistics. I have completed training almost about 7,000 students in logistics, in which about 1,000 students are in Dubai, 5,000 students are across India, I don't know where they are, few of them are in Chennai, maybe 1,000 students in Chennai, and they are not for a job. They are not in a job, they are in a career. For which there is no minimum word. That's why you don't have meaning of career. For a job, you don't have to study all this. You get a job. Even if you have careers, you get a job. The only job, for a job, for 18 years, physically fit, 18 years, and willing to work. What are the vela kadaku? A life will appear, vela kadaku, vela. Career kadaku. Career is something which you will build every day, brick by brick. Then suddenly you turn back after 60 years and see there's a big palace behind. That is career. Every 2-3 years you keep changing job, don't turn back after 60 years, no? Nothing is wrong. So please open up your eyes, wake up.
career has to be a lifetime pursuit, a goal. I want to set up a big IT company. How many of you want to become entrepreneurs? Self-employed in the business. Fantastic. Because for you guys to become businessmen or women, you need 5 to 10 years of work experience. And logistics and shipping gives you that opportunity. Many people who join logistics and shipping after 5-10 years land up setting up their own businesses. Correct? To play cricket, to see cricket, first you have to enter the cricket ground. Stadium. Only after entering, you see the cricket match, understand? Then you go and start fielding the ball. Correct? Become a fielder. That is the process to become entrepreneur. Not that you just finish MSc, BSc, computer science and become entrepreneur. Because the business world outside is like a forest, it's a jungle. Very thick forest, western grass, cobra snakes, monkeys, elephants, donkeys, mosquitoes. Everything will be there in the jungle. How do you handle that? Only when you work for 5 to 10 years, you have the experience, then you can set up business. So have a career, not a job. Don't look for a job. Please look for a career. Career is very important because if you don't have a career, you are in just an ordinary job. I'm sure many of your fathers, brothers, sisters, uncles, aunties, they're all in jobs and they don't have a career. You can hear me, all of you? Yeah. And if they don't have a career, you see them coming home very unhappy every day. But you see very unhappy employees around, a lot of unhappy employees. They say, hey, I'm working for IBM, I'm working for X-Y-Z every year, you see. But why when you're not smiling, why there's no laugh in your face, why you're crying all the time? I'm depressed, I'm not happy. My work is not exciting. Yes, sir. That is because they don't know what they want. If anybody asks you what you want, most difficult question. Today evening, go back home and say, Captain Kumar asked me what you want in life. What do I want in life? If suddenly God comes in front of you and says, okay, Ram, what do you want? Tell me. I'll give you. That is the confusion because human mind expands. Human mind expands. Your desires and wants are unlimited. When you have Levi's jeans of blue shade, you are looking for next Levi's jeans of gray shade. Oh, I have gray and blue. I got a white. I wish I had white jeans. Wow. So, as your mind is expanding, your needs are growing. But you also have to work accordingly to fulfill your needs. I want to give you a small formula because you are all science students, right? If you have pens, you can note down. Aspirations, A is directly proportional to 1 by E, 1 by effort. Aspirations are directly proportional to 1 by E. Effort. The two words in your life, do you remember? E and A. A is not expressive. E and A. E and A is efforts and aspirations. Efforts means someone. Prayatna. Right? Abhil, let us know what efforts mean. And aspirations means asking. Aspirations is your dreams. Okay? I will tell you a simple formula. If your efforts are more than your aspirations, you will be happy. That means you said, I want to have a job, 20,000 rupees. And you're working harder, you earn 21,000 rupees, you will be very happy. But your RSA is on Mount Everest, but you are sleeping at home and sleep. No effort, effort is zero. You will be unhappy because your desires are not met. Your aspirations have to be directly proportional to efforts. they can't be directly proportional. Which cross on my efforts, aspirations greater, you'll be happy. Aspirations, Asha is too much than efforts, you'll be unhappy person. So be careful. That's why you need a goal, you need a career. And a career, it should be your own decision. Why am I doing computer science? Oh, you know, my other brother is also joining for computer science, so we both get good friends in the college and come back, that's why I joined BSc. Same computer science over here. So, career choice has to be your own decision, because you have to live with yourself for lifelong.
Don't allow others to tell you what career to take. I'm warning you again. Don't listen to your girlfriends, boyfriends, mothers, fathers, aunties, uncles who talk about your career. You're a graduate, you're 18 plus. Make your own choice. You can take advice. Listen, inputs. Decision should be yours. You know why? Oh, you know why? I love my father so much, that's why I did whatever he wants. And you'll suffer for the rest of the life for 40 years, 50 years. That time you can't tell your father, oh daddy, I listened to you. That is, you know, because I love you so much. You have to say, what idiot you are. You should have told me that sorry, this is what you wanted to do. But by then you'll be 85 and you'll be 45. Nothing can be done. It should be your choice, because if you are happy out of it, you will be happy, and if you make a mistake, you will suffer. But that should be yours. But for somebody else's mistake, you can't suffer. Because when you make a mistake, no, you will change very fast. You will learn out of a mistake. If you make a mistake because of your parents or somebody, no, you told me not to do this, okay, no, as if you know you are morally correct and with us, and all the blame is on your parents or XYZ. No. Your life and your career will be with you. So make sure that it's your own decision. Identify your interests. You want to be outdoor person, you want to be indoor person, you want to do that. How many of you love traveling? How many of you love traveling, going, meeting people globally, worldwide? For you guys, logistics and shipping offers. There are 196 countries. Can you buy a ticket and visit 196 countries? It is possible. I visited 50 countries because I was working in logistics and shipping. I can never buy a ticket for 50 countries and go on to that. I'm not that rich. I also like to belong to middle class family, upper middle class family. But I enjoy every second, every moment in this industry, and now from a logistics professional, I've become a trainer. So that gives me more happiness because I see my students traveling now across the world. So it should be your own interest. What of confusions? Because I'm from logistics industry, I will come and say, hey guys, you know what, logistics laws. Let us say lawyer is standing here, hey, you know what, law is the best, do law. Then if I'm an engineer or some technical guy, I'll say, you know what, technology is too good. If I'm IT guy, I'll say, hey, you know what, IT is fantastic. Let's say I'm a movie actor, I'll say, hey, you know what, movies and TV rock, man, come on, let's get into media. If I'm a journalist, you say, oh, you know what, the nation wants to know why you will not join journalism. Come on, join journalism. Every field, every career is good. Now the problem is, there is Italy, Dosa. See, when I'm in Chennai at my home or sometime, you know, when my mother gives me a nice breakfast, only one item, I eat that, I shut my mouth and I come off. I'm staying in a hotel here. Morning, I got up, it's a beautiful hotel, zone hotel. I went for breakfast. I didn't know what to eat. One side dosa was there, vada, pongal, scrambled eggs, sausages, upma, puri. I was shocked. I didn't know what breakfast to have today. I was confused. Then I thought, life is giving you so many options, no? Very difficult to take a decision. So today life gives you many, many opportunities, many, many fields are there, many professions are there. So your life has become so much difficult, right? You have to find your interest. Now how do you find your interest? I am alumni of IIM Ahmedabad, Institute of Management Ahmedabad. My teacher taught me one small formula. You don't know what you want, correct? There are so many things, right? Whatever, idli, vada, dosa, you know, all those things are like. You go in front of each one and say, do I want idli? Look at it. No, I don't think I want idli. First, close. Say, I don't want this. I don't want this. I don't want this. No, because you are very clear what you don't want, correct? We are not clear what we want, correct? So first close the door, shut the doors on everything which you don't want. No, 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 no. Then left, finally you will be left with something. Most probably, I think that's what you want. That is called elimination theory. In science, it is called elimination theory. That is the way you choose what you want and what you want to do. Last but not least, our beloved APJ Abdul Kalam sir has told, and many, many people, I'm sure your faculty also will tell you, your principals, your dare to dream. Do you all dream?
Sir.
I'm not talking about dream having coffee with Katrina Kaif. I am talking about a dream which will not let you sleep, which will not let you be normal. Every day you are coming to the college, that one dream you have inside your minds, you know, that dream which will not let you sleep. What is that you want to do in life? Do you all have a purpose in life? No, not purpose. Once in Chennai, I asked one of my students, what is your purpose in life, sir? I want to be the youngest grandfather. I am not asking about such dreams. Yeah. Dreams which has value. What do you want to do for this country, for your family, for your life? It's very important. Please have a purpose. I am not saying don't have fun, don't have friends, don't have pleasure in life. Nothing like that. Because I am not a sannyasi, neither am I asking you to be a sannyasi. No. We are human beings because our Vedas tell that you have childhood, you have studenthood, you have professionalhood, you are supposed to go through grahasthasram, parenthood, then you have old age, then retirement, sannyasam comes after 6. Grahasthasra dharma, vidyadhi dharma, you know, like that. Today you are in studentship, next year, probably a couple of years later, you come into professionalship, where you are supposed to exercise and do some profession. Become a professional, then you get into grahasthasram, where you have your family and stuff like that. Then you have your, you know, real professionalship, again seniority, then you retire. Finally, you are vanaprastha. Vanaprastha means go to forest. Those days, at least here we can go to old age homes. If we don't go, our children will send us to old age homes. So dare to dream, okay? And dreams are free of cost. I have a dream. Next 25 years, I want to train more than 1 lakh students in logistics and shipping. And I want them all over the world from Indian Institute of Logistics. That's my dream. I'm living with the dream. So I already trained 7,000. First year in 2007, I trained only 60 students in 2007. It was very difficult. I said, Ammo, I'm only in 60 students I trained. When I will reach my 1 lakh target, probably 7,000 is over. Very soon I'll reach the next 10 years. You should have a dream. Without dream, life is like brinjal and potato and carrot. One fine day, somebody will come, chop you, make a curry and eat you, that's it. It can be society, it can be anybody. And your life has no meaning. So please dream, okay? And dreams are free of cost. Now that I have given you some soft skills and life skills, I'll come back to the... I will not mention the definition of logistics, but now you know the word for logistics is existing. Logistics is nothing but life. Everything revolves around logistics. I will tell you, as you see the more screens, you come to know how to tell. Like you have Iyer family, Sharma family, Chettiar family, Naidu family, Chaudhary family. You have logistics family. In the logistics family, there are 5 family members. Those 5 are order processing, inventory management, warehousing, transportation, and value-added services like customs clearance, packaging and EMV. These are five. Only these five. They look very simple. Entire world is rotating around these five. And where is your role now? You guys being IT guys, you guys being computer science, so-called computer science graduates, you are expected to use your technology, your knowledge to advance these functions. There is the marriage of IT and logistics is greatly managed. Today, every logistics and shipping company wants to place technology into their company, and every IT company wants to have a nice division of logistics division consulting domain where they can automize, digitalize, improvise, increase efficiency, operational efficiency of logistics operations. What does automation do? How computer science or information technology or computer applications, how they will, what they are supposed to do for logistics? They are supposed to increase the speed, reduce the cost, data management, reports, management reports, daily reports, scrutinize the data for taking decisions, so data analytics. So whatever you are learning in IT, you bring that and you are expected to apply that in logistics and shipping field or any other field. Application is very important. If you don't apply, there is no point in life. And many people think that logistics means, you know, carrying some sand in a lorry. No, it's not courier service. No, my dear friend, conceptually they may belong to logistics, but that is not logistics. You will see how big is the industry. How many countries are there in this world? Huh? 196, right? Can I tell you a story? Takes about 2 minutes, 3 minutes. Shall I? You're okay, you're not feeling sleepy, right? Sure. Okay. I don't know when it happened, about 5-10,000 years back. Jesus, Allah, Durga, Ganapati, all of them met at Cafe Coffee Day, they're having coffee. Okay. And because they were jobless, no, that time there were no human beings. They were really bored. You know, like Jesus was telling Allah, "Macha, bored. All the gods are sitting. You know, because gods, whatever they want, they'll get. No, so they have everything except happiness. They are not excited. There is no spice, no masala. Gods are excited. So Allah got up, and He created Adam. You know Adam? Heard about that Adam? Mr. Adam? He created Mr. Adam. Jesus saw that, Allah is an Adam, I also have to do something. No competition. He created Eve. Miss Eve. You heard about Eve also? Oh. See? He never heard about Adam, but Eve he heard. Okay. So Adam and Eve were created. Then, Allah and Jesus are looking at Ganpati. See, we both did something, what you did? Nothing. Ganpati, you know, big stomach and boss and lazy fellow and this thing, and what you fellows are doing, morning, and morning, they look up 50%. He's a lazy fellow, no? But Ganpati is putting mantras and all that, right? Ganpati, so he took one apple and mantrinch an apple, the same thing, you know. Apple mantra on the SSC, apple alaisa. Then he threw apple to Adam and Eve. It's a mantrich and apple, you know, it's all some specific powers about. That was long ago. Okay? Adam and Eve, what is the population? 2. Today, what is the global population? Okay, don't say you don't know. You are supposed to know because you are contributing with that. Come on. As Indians, yeah, we are future contributors. What is the global population? Huh? 7 words. 7 is nice. Come on girls, you are all silent. What is the global population? Very good. 7 billion and counting. I love that answer. 7 billion and counting. 1 billion is 100 crores. The global population is 700 crores and counting. I will throw some numbers at you students, friends. not for entertainment, but for you to understand the situation, how this global grid. Now, God has created Adam and Eve, and that's it, mantra mapping, and now population is growing. He's got very busy, all God's very busy. They all have their temples, churches, mosques, they're all busy, they're all excited, happy. But God's made a mistake. When they made human beings, did they give everything to everybody? When they created this Mother Earth, how much portion of the earth is covered with water? 70% is water, but also salt water. We can't have this fresh water. We have to use desalination plant for it. Anyway, so 196 countries, did God give everything to everybody? Do you think gods are intelligent or crazy? Or both? God made a mistake. Coffee producer, no problem. Caffeine. Ellarkum, ellar kudukalam. God did not give everything to everybody. So everybody wants something from everybody. If God would have given everything to everybody, then nobody will talk to anybody. Because God didn't give anything to anybody, or everything to anybody, and everybody wants something from everybody. And that is why today there is international trade. Exim antar jatiya vyaparam. Mam business chestam. Tilla kavutha avarika? Avarika tilu. Ayyo, I heard Coimbatore is full of Telugu people also. Okay, I don't see much. Okay, if you understand that, really. Why you are silent, man? Okay, never mind. So, because of inequality of distribution, I put it in social sciences. Inequal distribution of natural resources between the countries, 196 countries, everybody is doing business with everybody, the international trade. 196 countries doing business with 196 countries. Imagine the size of the global trade. $50 trillion is the size of the global trade. 1 trillion is 1000 billion. 1 billion is 1000 million. All in US dollars. $50 trillion. Indian GDP is $2 trillion. Two. In that 50. America is 12. America is 4 times larger than India. But American population is 4 times lesser than India, 35 crores or 30 crores. Now, my dear friends, understand one more thing, what is happening in India. Because if you understand this, you will take it seriously in your life. If you don't understand this, I don't think Jesus Allah Ram also can do anything. Australia is 5 times larger than India. And India is producing 1 Australian population every year. And 1 Australian population is 30 million, 3 crores. 3 crores, 300 lakhs. Indian population is 125 crores and counting. 1.25 billion is Indian population. Is producing 3 crores every year, which is 1 Australian population. So logically, my friends, if 21 years back India produced 3 crores babies, after 21 years, that is this year, there should be 3 crore graduates coming out like you. Right? They grow up, they go to KG class, they go to 10 plus 2 degree, correct? It's not happening. My dear friends, out of 3 crore babies India is producing, 10% of the babies, 30 lakh babies are dying on the day of their delivery. Another 30 lakh babies are dying during the first year of the birth because the mother could not give them milk, there is no shelter, there is no fan, there is no AC, they are on the streets, there is no food, there is no ferric, there is no paracetamol medicine, there is no phenophyll medicine because of malaria babies are dying. Our Indian 30 lakh babies are dying because of lack of food. Here, you throw coffee, you throw dal rice, you throw chicken, you spend money on pizzas. I'm not saying it's bad, but I'm also drawing your attention before you waste your food and everything. 30 lakh babies are dying because they don't have malaria tablets. 30 lakh, sorry. out of these 3 crore babies, 760 lakh babies are out in the first year. Dead. Now left is 2.3 or 2.4 crore babies. 30 lakh babies are malnutrition, unhealthy, blind, deaf, dumb, handicapped, whatever. Now you are left with 2 crore babies. In the 2 crore babies, we all belong to the 30 lakh elite club, I call it. Most fortunate babies of the 30 lakhs, all of us. Because in the 2 crore babies every year, only 30 lakh people become graduates. Every year, India is producing 30 lakh graduates. Very lucky we are. 30 lakh graduates from 3 crore babies. And in this 30 lakhs, India is producing 7 lakh engineers, 2 lakh MBAs, 5 lakh BSc, 7 lakh BCom, balancer, MSc, MCom, MA, blah blah blah. So how many graduates India is producing every year? 30 lakhs. How many zeros are there? 30 lakhs. Now, you're all intelligent people. I know. When I look at you, you look intelligent. Let me put a question to you. Do you think India is producing 30 lakh jobs every year? Just 3 million jobs every year? Does India is producing 3 million jobs every year? What does your logic say? India managed to produce 30 million babies every year. But does India is producing 3 million jobs every year? My question to you as grown up Indian citizens, Indian adults, you all. Does India produce 30 lakh jobs every year? No. Huge unemployment. Huge competition. Now what happens to last year 30 lakhs? What happens to next year 30 lakhs? We will not be competing with them. What I am trying to attract your attention is, my dear friends, there is a huge, huge competition outside this college. When you step out the college and say, I am a graduate, come on, come to the race, let's compete. Open ground. Everybody is competing with everybody. You cannot feel it. You cannot see it. But it is there. You know how it is there? You won't get what you want unless you work hard. Push it. Earn it. Sweat it. Hard work. Fight it. Then only you will get the stand of life. You are competing with 30 lakh graduates every year. That is the first news I want to tell you. It is good news, it's bad news, both. So, don't be herd mentality and go in one direction. Think smartly. Take something which people do not know or people awareness is not there. And you have to be something special. If so many BSc IITs are coming out, you have to have something special in you. USP, unique selling proposition. That logistics can add to you. I see on the cake. 5 modes of transportation. Everywhere, don't you see technology being used in any? Every mode, technology is there or not? Huh? Yeah. Even a taxi wala, what is Uber? Ola? They are taxi companies or technology companies? Huh? Uber and Ola are not taxi companies, they look like taxi companies. Many companies, you think that they are that companies, they are not. Uber and Ola are technology companies. They have made an application using which you can book a taxi. So for your mind, it is taxi company. They are technology companies. You pay money not for the taxi, you pay the money or whatever incentive for their technology, for using their application, for using the apps. Amazon.com, what company is that? Very good. Who said that? Very good. Fantastic. What's your name? Vikram, give a hand to Vikram.
Ravan Vikram, Manod Kilgode.
Amazon.com, people say is an e-commerce company. Nonsense. Amazon.com is a logistics company. Amazon.com is a technology company, not commerce company. Amazon.com manufactured one platform where in this platform they got two people together, buyer and seller. They don't buy and sell, they make you and the buyer and the seller come together, that's all. And they do inventory management, they do distribution, they do transportation, they do warehousing, they do packaging, they do labeling, they do customs clearance. They are a logistics company. People, newspaper fellows, don't trust newspaper fellows, whatever is written in the paper is not true. E-commerce. This is a technology company which is using technology and logistics together. That is Amazon.com. Understand the companies, you're all user intellect. Don't believe others. Somebody will come and say Amazon is an e-commerce company. We tend to believe on the face value. No. I can give you 100 examples. You'll be surprised if I tell you that. I'm very proud of this guy. This guy never studied logistics. And whenever I pass by and see, I met the CEO's son in some seminar and I felt very nice inside my heart. Wow. The founder is not a very well educated MBA logistics guy. Kovai Falamadriya, what business they are into? No, that is what they think and that's what you think. I don't think that at all. Kovai Falamadriya, he will procure fruits and vegetables. What he does? Procure fruits and vegetables, bring it to a very nice looking air conditioned warehouse in the city, beautiful warehouse. All the vegetables are nicely stocked and packed and kept there with air conditioned warehouse. You all go there, buy them. He will help you do onward logistics because if you say, hey, you know, there's a wedding and I need 100 kg potato, 200 kg fruits, he said, well, you go, I will give you door delivery. This guy is a logistics guy who does logistics in fruits and vegetables. He is not a fruit and vegetable trader. No. He is buying 10 rupees vegetable there. He is adding value addition. What is the value addition he is doing? Go ahead, follow up to you. Let's say he buys Uti carrots. And what value addition he is doing? Logistics, transportation, warehousing, distribution. He's the guy who's giving you logistics service provider for vegetables and fruits. I see him like that. I don't see him like a mango seller and buyer. No. But he has to manage the inventory because he must know how many mangoes, carrots and potatoes are being sold. That is inventory management he has to do so that he knows for which product the logistics service is required. So whichever product the sales is high, he will procure that product and provide logistics service so to reach the consumer. One slide. Adhavna. Purida? Let's all come. Greek and Latin. Very simple. So my dear friends, why I am trying to tell you is many companies, you think what they are not what I think. Or probably they are what I think. Because I look at it differently. So logistics and shipping is there everywhere. I believe from Coimbatore, lot of cargo is flying every day morning, Kothimilli, Karvepakku and all those things, you know, to Qatar and Dubai and Yemen and air cargo, flowers from Uti and all that. Textiles from Tirupur in containers, not in air cargo. But LMW, all engineering products. Coconut husk, I believe Pollachi is full of coconut trees. So all the coconut byproducts, coconut shell, dry coconut, coconut husk, coconut fiber, every damn thing is being exported. There is logistics and shipping around you. You are not seeing it. It is there. Every day in life is there. You will get a shock if I tell you something. Let us say, for example, your semester fees is about 30,000, 40,000 per semester. Every day for you to come to the college and go back to the college, what is the cost? Be honest, sir. Don't say, sir, 10 rupees coming, sir, bus ticket, 10 rupees going, sir, 20 rupees, sir, that's all, sir, nonsense. Add your coffee, pocket money, tea, chai, gacha, everything, weekly, movie, then what is one fun ball expenditure? Tell me, if you add that expenditure, will it be more than your semester fee or less than your semester fee? Huh? Come on, mama. More than the semester, ma'am. So the logistics cost, ma'am, for them to do one semester is more than the actual cost of the service. That is logistics cost. Transportation. Pocket money. Once in a week, only running. Bajrangi Biden has come. You know, we have to. What, daddy? Come on, you know. You understand how this, daddy? I know daddy also proper, they love us, you know. Their daddies love them. His daddy loves us. So now continues. The logistics cost of doing your semester fee, one semester, is more than your semester fee. 100% of the logistics cost. You're getting the point, what I'm trying to tell you? The logistics is everywhere around you. Whether you like it or not, it is there. In law, what do you think? You come to the college every day, what is it called? Transport? Bus stop where you will be waiting, correct? For the bus. It is where housing storage. You are waiting there for the bus. Okay. You wear uniform, whatever ID card has come, packaging and labeling. You are labeling yourself, you know what, I belong to GRD. You are putting a label on yourself. No? Logistics is there in everybody's life. It is in your blood. It is there. Without logistics, there is no human civilization. Without your computers, this world will survive. Without internet, this world will live. Stone age will come. Because 50 years from now, crude oil is going. Finish it. No more oil, petrol. So better buy a bicycle and give it. Or buffaloes and horses. 50 years, that is when you and I retire. All of us will retire very soon. In 50 years, what will happen? So, bring some nice horse maybe, keep it ready for a season. And make a horse cart. Or a popular cut, whatever you want. Because the world is going to run short of hydrocarbon resources in the next 50 years. So decide what you want to do. So logistics is so important. I will not go into rail transport, I will not go into road transport. Because if you understand shipping, shipping is the mother of all transportations. 90% of the global trade happens by ships. And if you understand shipping, you're part of the global trade and you can explore and go anywhere and set up any business you want, provided you have that aspiration and dreams in you. Pipeline, I will not talk. Sea transportation, yes. 90% of global trade. You know one container, you have seen container anytime? The container has changed the life of people globally. 700 crore, 7 billion population. Everybody, tomorrow you have one lorry of cargo, one truck of cargo. You can become an international trader if you know logistics. You know how to reach the cargo there. What is the process involved in trading, buying and selling? India has 8,000 kilometers of sea coast from West Bengal to Gujarat. India has more than 300 ports. China today has about 1,000 ports. My dear friends, in next 30 to 40 years, India will have 1,000 ports. How many ports are there in Tamil Nadu today? Pretty good in Chennai? Kochi is not in Tamil Nadu, yeah? Chennai, Tuticorin, Pondicherry, Nagapattinam, Karaikal, Ennore, Kattupalli, blah blah blah. About 10 ports are there, and my dear friends, Tamil Nadu will have another 20-30 ports in the next 25 years. Port industry is a very big industry where you can come and make a big career. You can retire as a CEO of a port. And girls, don't think that there are no girls in logistics and shipping industry. The biggest problem is the term shipping. If you go and tell your father or mother today, or your friend, or your sister, auntie, somebody who's never seen the world, you know what, ma? Today we had a seminar on shipping. You know, I think I want to join shipping. Oh, no, no, no. You cannot join shipping. You should not go on the ship. First, explain them what is the meaning of shipping. Shipping has synonyms. Shipping means actually exporting the cargo. Shipping means actually going on the water. Shipping has many meanings, right? So tell your parents, Amma, this shipping is not going on the ship. I can sit in Chennai, I can sit in Coimbatore, I can sit in Delhi, Bombay, or I can sit in the kitchen with my laptop, with my data card. I can even work from home. It's like any other IT company, IT work only. Because your parents, you know, in 2007-2008, when one parent used to come with a female student, no? Oh, sir, shipping is very good, sir, and I show him big ships and all those things, no? They used to be, no, Captain, I can't send my daughter on the ship. But believe me, today, there are girl cadets on ships. When we were cadets, almost 15-20 years back, only boys were cadets. Today, every ship has girl cadets. The female captains are there in India, female chief officers are there. So it is nothing called, you know, girl, boy, nothing. Today, there is no difference between girl and a boy. The only difference, if you have a boy, you have to spend on the boy much. Girls are very responsible. Boys are an extra expenditure, that's all. Nothing else. Then they say boys are liability. Girls will take care of us, you know. When we become old and all that, our daughters will. What, you take care of your parents? Okay, fine. The parents will listen, they'll be happy. So please tell them, shipping, the meaning of shipping is not going on the ship, not merchant navy carrier. I belong to merchant navy carrier. Shipping means sitting in the office, controlling the cargo, the process, the information, the finances, helping the buyer and seller to physically move the cargo. That is shipping. I don't want to get into the process of logistics, but this slide is very important for me. Let us say there is a beautiful, efficient Coimbatore horse, and we put that efficient horse in between 99 donkeys, and we come back after 1 year, and you look for your horse. How the horse will be behaving like? Because however efficient that horse is, once you take that horse and push it in between 99 donkeys, no? Poor fellow will slowly forget that I am at the horse and slowly, because everywhere donkey. So, you know, you feel that is a reality and you also behave like a donkey. Now, the second experiment we will do, because we are all science students, right? We should do experiments in life, social experiments. Now, we take the one ordinary donkey and put the donkey in between 99 horses and we will come back after 1 year. And then you look for your donkey. Where is the donkey? And suddenly when you look at the donkey, how the donkey will be behaving as? This donkey will start behaving like a horse. My dear friends, why I am giving you this example is, it is not only important how good and how bad you are, it is also important with whom you are rubbing your shoulders. What kind of profession and business and atmosphere you are there. Atmosphere means not able to AC cabins and all that. What kind of industry you are there is very important, because however good you may be, gold and platinum, you go and keep rubbing against copper and silver, your value will come down. Be very careful, be choosy with what industry you are getting into, with whom you are rubbing your shoulders. See value. If you don't rub your shoulder, your value will go off. You become less valuable. In logistics and shipping, you are dealing with exporters, you are dealing with importers, you are dealing with banks, you are dealing with ports, warehouses, customs officials, traders, logistics service providers. You are in a global trade, every day rubbing shoulders with everybody who's running, who's dynamic, who's aspirational, who wants to make things happen. Then you also become dynamic, aspirational, you also want to make things happen. Even assuming you are a lazy guy, you will change. That is why I showed this slide, that you should be in a dynamic world and atmosphere. containers. 50% of the global trade is carried by containers. Container logistics is a huge area. You can be part of container logistics. Sir, I am IT. What I am supposed to do in this? Inventory management. Where are the empty boxes? How many containers are out? How many containers are in? How many containers are damaged? How many containers are gone for equipment maintenance and repairs? How many are being loaded? How many are being discharged? How many ships are carrying? How many boxes? How many are confiscated or how many are at customs problems? Customer service with technology. Where is my cargo? How do you tell where is your cargo? GPS, RFIDs, date of delivery, date of taking over, transit, position of the cargo, online, tracking, cargo tracking services, all is information technology. Don't think today every industry has IT. There is no industry without IT. So you can be part of container logistics. Next. If you like mathematics, you really like physics. How many of you like physics here? Really like physics. Okay? You guys, anybody likes mathematics with drawing, scale, pencil, one-point divider? Yes, you guys should come into heavy lift logistics. Calculate center of gravity, what kind of chain, wire, how do I lash this cargo, how do I transport this cargo, what is the planning to do, drawings, you know, like a six-hour puzzle, you put them together, you break them together, how do you take it forward, operations, a beautiful world. Heavy lift logistics. How many of you guys love bikes and cars here? Good. I asked how many of you love physics and maths? Nobody raises hands. The moment I said how many of you? Okay, at least I'm happy they're awake here. Guys, if you like automotive industry, if you like that being around with bikes, if you like being around with cars, in auto logistics, barcoding, making sure transporting, distribution of these automotive vehicles to third world countries, developing countries around the world, help them. Imagine you transport one auto, Bajaj auto or TVS auto, to a place in Afghanistan, and probably a girl called Malala may be traveling by that auto for her school. Or maybe a lady, pregnant lady is going for delivery in that auto, what you supply, what you made sure that it reaches there, that is the power of transportation, God. It will change your lives. You can use your passion and logistics to change somebody else's life. So you like auto logistics, a very emerging industry. And one more thing I want to tell you. You know, olden days in America, there was a place called Detroit. You all know Detroit? And Detroit was famous for manufacturing cars. Every car in America was manufactured in Detroit, okay? So they used to say, hey, where are you living? Hey, you know what? I live in Detroit of America. I know I'm in America, Detroit. My dear friends, today, Nama Chennai, Nama Tamil Nadu is Detroit of the world. We are manufacturing cars for the entire world. We are the net exporter of the cars in the world. You are not proud? You are Chennai, you are Tamil Nadu, my friends. Come on, feel proud. Show me that you are proud. Oh my God. No life, huh? Did you eat breakfast, huh? Which place you are from? Amen. Our India has become the net export of the cars. You go to Amen, you will see all Indian automobiles. A lot of Indian stuff. Though we like spices from Yemen and some dry fruits and other things. Middle East is the one place where we export a lot of automobiles. And we get from Middle East a lot of hydrocarbon products, petroleum products. So you guys can be in auto logistics. Bulk logistics where you transport, manage, store, load, discharge, bulk coal, bulk urea, fertilizer. See, at the end your knowledge has to be useful, right? Has to be applied, right? Logistics and shipping is a very practical industry where you can actually utilize your knowledge. It is a desk job, you can move around, meet people, shake hands, and do something, and you can see it happening in front of your eyes. It is indirectly a national service. I was so happy when somebody told that, you know, guy, you are teaching auto logistics. The company came to me today. Every company has a logistics in the logistics division. Any company, pharmaceutical, auto, agri, steel, tobacco, you name it, they have a logistics division. Without logistics today, nothing happens. However, I'm a vegetarian, so I don't know much about this logistics. I kept away from it. This is livestock logistics. Australia, Europe, India exports lot of livestock to Middle East. Halal, machine chopping. And in Middle East, there are how many Gulf GCC countries? Are seven. Seven GCC countries. And entire Middle East is got about 30-40 countries with Islamic cultural background, where the consumption of non-vegetarian is very high. They need a lot of meat, protein. So India, Australia and Europe, and if you love breeding goats and buffaloes and cows and stuff like that, you can breed them, you can export them, they would love to have them there. So simple machine, you put 1,000 cows, buffaloes or whatever, only packets will come out. All the bones will go for urea, and some bone powder goes into sugar. In Middle East, when they manufacture sugar, they put slight bone powder for something else, some other reason. Every part of our cattle is used. You know, what a super life they live on. Sometimes I feel animals are more useful than human beings. Every part of this cattle is used for human existence, human civilization. So that is livestock logistics. Oh, I hate this logistics. I don't like this. This cargo can walk, talk, bark. This cargo, whatever you do, this cargo is never happy. Lot of paperwork is involved in this cargo handling. All other cargo will keep quiet. The nice cargo you handle, load, discharge, keep it rain and all, no problem. This cargo very difficult. So if anybody likes to play with danger, can join passenger logistics. I like to deal with cargo, which will not talk, which will not move. I love that area. Passenger logistics, very big area. Normally Asians are not allowed. Middle East Asians, we are not allowed. This industry is controlled by Americans and Europeans, white skinned people. Our skin is not white. Not actually being white, we may be actually white, our Kashmiri brothers and some South Indians are really fair and white, but I'm not trying to skip being white. Europeans and Africans are called white people because they call all of us black people. Black people means doesn't mean Africans. That was earlier, not now. Olden days, Americans and Europeans used to call all of us blacks. And today they have a black president. So, it's in your hands what you do with what you have. A guy 20 years back at age of 30 was sitting in Kenya having a cigar smoke. Barack, Hussein, Barack Hussein Obama, a Muslim from Kenya, Africa, 30 years old, did his law, ML, got married and had some kids and all that. And thinking, what should I do now? America says they'll give me citizenship. America is giving me a job to become a lawyer in their country. Grandfather, what should I do? Grandfather and grandson were sitting with a smoke, though smoking is injurious to health. And they were talking. 20 years back, Barack Hussein Obama, who's a black guy, who's a Muslim guy or Muslim origin, America gives him a job and he thinks, what should I do? In 20 years, my dear friends, in 20 years, by the time he becomes 50 years old, he becomes president of the United States of America. In 20 years. No Muslim, no black guy will ever even apply for the post of president or even look at the post of president. I'm in America, I should not be even thinking of it. see the guts, see the aspiration, see the dream, see the passion. 20 years is more than sufficient. You can reach wherever you want. But you have to mudilu. Strong willpower is required. Once your willpower, you reach anywhere you want. So I don't encourage you to get into passenger logistics. Offshore industry, hydrocarbon industry, very big in Middle East. By the way, for those who wants to, anybody wants to desperately go to America, US is my destination, land of opportunities. One, anybody here, boys? Why you don't want to go to America? What's wrong in that? Why you are dreaming? It's land of opportunities, nothing wrong. What? Ayyo, amchikare uttita engiyo pomaatare. Oh my God. If you work in Dubai, we have signed, there are somebody, you will be hired, you have the desire inside, you are expressing. Come on guys, express yourself. If you don't dream, if you don't tell your dream to the world will never help you to dream. Tell the world what you want to do and the world will help you. You can make note of a website called Federal Maritime Commission, FMC, especially you. There are 5,000 logistics companies registered on the website in America. Federal Maritime Commission, FMC. Go to Dubai. We have signed more than 100 MOUs with 100 logistics shipping companies in Dubai. Work there for 3 years, 4 years, get experience, get a qualification logistics and shipping, because many of you think through IT you can reach Europe and America and have success. Imagine if you had logistics and IT, it's a deadly cocktail. 5,000 companies on the website, registered logistics service providers in America you have. Make 5,000 biodata once you have 3 years work experience and say, I'm a young Indian lady, I'm a graduate, I'm a postgraduate in logistics, I'm blah blah blah, I worked 3 years in so and so company in Dubai, I would like to apply for a job, for a junior position in your company, sir. I'm willing to fly anytime with short notice. Thanks and best regards. Please find my attached CV, please find my attached passport, please find my attached experience certificate, please find my credentials, send 5,000 applications. One job? Everybody. I feel so, our Indians are so lazy. Sorry, don't hear certain statements. You agree? He's laughing. If you want to do something, you want to go to America, don't leave the dream. Leave your dream. Go behind it under any cost. I know, one of them, you know, some of, I finished my law and one of my colleagues in the office, she also wanted to do law. She joined the law program and her mother-in-law said, no, how can you do law, no, not required. Stop it. Mother-in-law was scared. Oh my God,
you are captured, broken.
I'm scared. I sometimes feel women are the first enemies for women. Surprised. Don't listen to people. You live your dream, go behind the dream, earn your dream, achieve. That's why it is called chasing your dream. Dream, okay, their dream is there, you are sitting here. Oh, nice dream, I have seen. The dream will never, you will never go to the dream, you will never make it. Chase your dreams, go behind it, it will happen. But don't sit in your house in a cozy bedroom and, oh, okay, I wish I am in America, I wish I am. You will never be in America that way, you will be in hospital because you are sleeping for 6 months. Correct? You have to chase your dreams. Chase your dreams is the word. Please remember that. I was 16 when I wanted to go to America. And they told me, yes, you can go, but you join the ship. That ship will come back to India after 6 months, 1 year. I was 16 years old. I have to take a call whether I'm going back home, Vijayawada or engineering college, or ship is waiting for me to take me to America. I have to take a decision in Chennai, in Paris corner. I said, I'll miss my mom, dad, and my sister, my brother. I was only 16, imagine what would have gone through my mind. I'm standing there in Chennai port. The ship is there. I can go to America next 1 month. My first American port was Houston, Texas. First time I had my McPea burger in Houston, in Texas. It was so nice feeling. And I bought my sister a small calculator. Believe me, she still has it after 15, 20 years. It's been 20 years. Still she has a small calculator, TI, Texas Instruments calculator, $10. That today gives me a feel high. My sister says, hey, you know bro, do you remember that yellow color calculator you bought me when you were 16 years old?
20 years back, oh wow, did I do it? And we both sit down there and open that and see the pen. It's not broken, you know. That's what my sister kept it. I feel very proud. So it's not about having dreams.
Or anywhere you should be, you know, going chasing your dreams. Gas logistics. Anybody loves chemistry here? Do you really love chemistry? I'm surprised. Oh, it is not there in your syllabus, right? Chemistry. But anyways, if you love valves, pipes, pressure, and you know, global hydrocarbon gas, India imports lots of gas. We have a lot of gas terminals. Handling, storage, distribution of gas logistics is a big area. MN supplies a lot of gas to India and other. We have gas terminals. Middle East itself has a lot of gas ports. You can be part of hydrocarbon industry, liquid logistics, gas industry, hydrocarbon, a huge industry in Middle East. So if you are part of logistics and shipping, you can have a great career there. It's your choice. Project cargo logistics, other type of logistics. Various types of project cargo. Everywhere you need logistics and shipping. What cargo is this? Timber. India imports timber or exports timber? India imports timber. We stop cutting trees. South Africa, Malaysia, Burma, Bangladesh, we import timber from. Timber logistics, very special area. Now let me ask you, 10 years you are part of logistics of timber. You know buyer, you know seller, you are transporting timber, storage, warehouse, loading, discharging, distributing. What will you do after 10 years? Logical, what will happen? Only very few people like me become teachers. Many of my friends who are in the trading industry came into logistics. Many of my friends who are in logistics went into international trade. When we sit down, you know, for a get together or party, when we just sit down and all are talking together. Okay, there's one guy that needed education also, not training also. Such a big industry, this industry needs manpower. It's a dynamic industry. So this is different logistics, cement logistics. Another area of logistics is cement logistics. Door-to-door logistics. Industry is growing. I'll tell you good news or bad news, whatever you can feel like, because if you are part of logistics industry tomorrow, as I told you, IT and logistics is a deadly combination. IT industry in India is only $60 billion. $60 billion. Logistics industry in India is $200 billion. So logistics industry is 3 times larger than your IT industry. Because as of today, your IT and logistics. My industry is 3 times larger than IT industry. So, if you add both rail cargo, exim companies, all manufacturing companies, ports, warehouses, CFS, ICDs, you are required, all of these companies you require. Job profiles, entry level, training executives, you have to learn first 3 years. This is for the girls, especially this slide is for the girls. Because I am fed up telling girls that you can be part of logistics and shipping industry. You know, in a class of 60 students, I have Miss Ruksana Vora. Nobody has a pen? Nobody wants to write, at least? Not interested about this woman? Who is a managing director of Sai Maritime? She is in logistics and shipping. And she is an MD. Ruksana Vora. Okay, next one. Nadia Abdul Aziz Mahmoud Al Khan. She's a lady because she's a Muslim lady and she's a Burqa lady. They're not supposed to show their face. So for respecting religion, I've not put her face here. This, why did I put this name is, she's a Muslim lady and she's in the logistics and shipping, wearing a Burqa. Ms. Shanta Martin, CEO, All Cargo Global Logistics Limited. You can easily remember one name now. Ms. Shanta Martin,
All Cargo Global Logistics Limited. It's a 5,000 crores company. She's the CEO of this company and she's a differently abled lady. You know, she's handicapped one leg, she has got some polio attack lady. Can you imagine a lady who's 45, 50 years old is the MD of a company, 5,000 crores company, All Cargo Global Logistics, and she's an Indian lady and she's there, you can call her. Call Shantar Patin, tell Capt.V.J told me your name that you are the MD here. Just talk to her, nothing wrong. Call all these ladies, they know me. Just call them. And just imagine being at the head of the company. With Sanjam Sahi Gupta, there is a thing called Vista website and Vista Association, WISTA, Women in Shipping and Trade Association. Vista Association. And she is a director of Sitara Shipping and she is 35 years old, she is my friend. She is director of a company already. You have to dream. Of course, these are father's company, so she became director at 35. If not, it will take 45 or 50, that's it. These are all living examples I'm giving.